Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel Legal Decipher. In the previous video, we had discussed about Chapter 10 of the Indian Penal Code 1860. If you have not seen that video, you can go and check it. The link is in the description below. In today's video, we are going to discuss about Chapter 11 of the Indian Penal Code. We'll go through the chapter and try to understand the substance therein. So if you are new here, please like and subscribe to my channel to get the video notifications. So let's get started. So today we are going to learn chapter 11 that talks about offenses against public justice. So offenses against public justice may be classified under the following heads. What are those heads? They are giving or fabricating false evidence. Section 191 to 200 deals with this head. And then causing disappearance of evidence, that is dealt with by section 201 to 204. It also deals with false personation. Sections 205 and 229 talks about this head. Abuse of process of court. Sections 206 to 210 deal with this head. False charge of offense, section 211 talks about this. Screening and harboring offenders, section 201, 212 and 216A talks about this head. Offenses by public servants that are dealt with by section 217 to 223 and 225A. Resisting lawful apprehension, that is dealt with by section 224 and 225 and 225B. Violation of valid conditions, that is dealt with by section 227 and 229A. And contempt of court, that is dealt with by section 228, and disclosure of identity is dealt with by section 228A. So these are the heads and these are the sections that deal with those heads. Now let's move on with this chapter and try to understand what are these offenses that are mentioned under these heads. So first we will move on with section 191 that talks about giving false evidence. It basically defines giving false evidence. It says that when a person who is legally bound by an oath to state the truth, so a person is legally bound by an oath to state the truth, he has made an oath that he will speak only the truth and he makes any statement which is false, so it can be said that he has given a false evidence. Now explanation says that a statement is within the meaning of this section whether it is made verbally or otherwise. So verbal or oral or written or any kind of statement that is given is covered under this section. And another explanation says that a false statement as to the belief of the person attesting is within the meaning of this section. So the false statement as to the belief of that person who is attesting is within the meaning of this section, and a person may be guilty of giving false evidence by stating that he believes a thing. So if that person is saying that I believe that this is the thing, then if it is false, then it will be considered as a false evidence which he actually does not believe. So if he actually does not believe that thing but still he says in his statement that I believe this thing, then he is thought to be making a false evidence. And it also covers those cases where he states that he knows a thing which he does not know. Let's move on to section 192. It talks about fabricating false evidence. So it defines fabricating false evidence. It says under this section, if a person causes any circumstance to exist or makes any document containing a false statement, so either he is trying to make a circumstance or cause a circumstance so that such circumstance exists, or he makes any document that contains a false statement so as to mislead the person dealing with the matter, then it can be said that he has fabricated a false evidence. So he has literally made up this false evidence. And now section 193 to 195 provides for the punishment for giving false evidence or for fabricating false evidence. So section 193 says that whoever intentionally gives false evidence in any judicial proceeding or fabricates a false evidence for the purpose of being it used in any stage of a judicial proceeding, then he shall be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine. And whoever intentionally gives or fabricates false evidence in any other case, then he shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 3 years and shall also be liable to fine. So if it is a judicial case, he will be imprisoned for up to 7 years, and if it is any other case, he will be imprisoned for up to 3 years. An explanation says a trial before a court martial is a judicial proceeding. And another explanation says that an investigation directed by law preliminary to a proceeding before a court of justice is a stage of judicial proceeding. So if it is a preliminary stage of a proceeding, then it is also a judicial proceeding and it comes under this section, though that investigation may not take place before a court of justice. So it does not need to take place before a court of justice. Now another explanation says that an investigation directed by a court of justice according to law and conducted under the authority of a court of justice is a stage of judicial proceeding, though that investigation may not take place before a court of justice. So an investigation also forms part of a judicial proceeding. Section 194 talks about giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of capital offense. So he is basically giving or fabricating a false evidence, and his intention behind so is to procure conviction. He wants that a person gets conviction of capital offense. So in that case, he will be punished with imprisonment for life or with rigorous imprisonment for a term which may extend to 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. And if by doing so, an innocent person is thereby convicted and executed, then this person who has given such false evidence shall be punished either with death or by a punishment herein before described. Now, section 195 talks about giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of offense punishable with imprisonment for life or imprisonment. So if he is giving or fabricating false evidence and has the intention that whoever is to be convicted on basis of such false and fabricated evidence, that person will be punished with imprisonment for life or any kind of imprisonment. Then in that case, this person who has so fabricated or given false evidence, this person will be imprisoned for life or for a term up to 7 years or upwards, and shall be punished as a person convicted of that offense would be liable to be punished. Now section 195A talks about threatening any person to give false evidence. So what happens if a person threatens another person that you have to go and give false evidence, otherwise you will face serious consequences? So if he threatens like that to any other person and that person has to go and give false evidence due to such threatening, then in that case, this person who is so threatening to give false evidence will be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 7 years or with fine or with both. And if any innocent person is convicted and sentenced in consequence of such false evidence with death or imprisonment for a term more than 7 years, then the person who threatens shall be punished with the same punishment and sentenced in the same manner and to the same extent as such innocent person is punished and sentenced. So whatever punishment that innocent person had to suffer, this person who threatened to give such false evidence will suffer the same punishment. Now sections 196 to 200 prescribes the punishments for using false evidence as genuine. So section 196 talks about using evidence known to be false. So you know that the evidence is false, but you are still using it. So whoever corruptly uses or attempts to use a false evidence as a true evidence, he shall be punished with in the same manner as if he had given false evidence or as if he has fabricated false evidence. Now, section 197 talks about issuing or signing false certificate. So whoever issues or signs any certificate that is required by law to be given or signed, and it is to be admissible as evidence and this person knows or believes that such certificate is false in any material point, still he signs it, then he shall be punished in the same manner as if he has given false evidence. Now, section 198 talks about using as true a certificate known to be false. So now that certificate that was false is now used as a true certificate. So whoever does that will be punished with in the same manner as if he has given false evidence. Now, section 199 talks about false statements made in declaration which is by law receivable as evidence. So whoever has made any declaration before a court of justice or any public servant or other person who is bound to receive such evidence as a fact and he is authorized by law to do so, and this person has made a false statement before him. So in that case, if that false statement touches any point that is material to the object for which the declaration is made or used, then this person shall be punished with the same manner as if he has given false evidence. Section 200 says that using as true such declaration knowing it to be false. And if anyone uses such declaration knowing it that it is false, but this person who is so using such declaration shall be punished in the same manner as if he has given false evidence. Explanation says that a declaration which is inadmissible merely upon the ground of such informality is a declaration within the meaning of section 199 and 200. Now section 201 to section 204 talks about causing disappearance of evidence. So section 201 says that causing disappearance of evidence of offense or giving false information to screen offender. So whoever causes the evidence of an offense to disappear, or he gives false information so that the offender does not get caught, so this person who is so causing the disappearance of such evidence or giving false information to screen such offender, this person will be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years, and shall also be liable to fine if the offense which he knows or believes to have been committed is punishable with death. Section 202 talks about intentional omission to give information of offense by person bound to inform. So whoever knowing or having reasons to believe that an offense has been committed and intentionally omits to give any information respecting that offense. So he knows of the offense, but he has intentionally omitted to give any information regarding that offense which he was legally bound to give, then he will be punished with imprisonment for either description for a term which may extend to 6 months, or with fine, or with both. Now section 203 talks about giving false information respecting an offense committed. Now he has given evidence, but he has given false evidence in respect to an offense that he knows that has been committed. So in that case, he will be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. And explanation says that in section 201 and 202, the word offense includes any act committed at any place that is outside India, which if committed in India would be punishable under these sections. Now section 204 talks about the punishment for a person who destroys a document or electronic record to prevent its production as evidence in a court. So that document would have been used as an evidence in a court, but this person destroyed such document or electronic record to prevent it from producing before a court as an evidence. So in that case, this person who has so destroyed such evidence shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now section 205 talks about false personation. It relates to false personation. It says it punishes a person who personates another in civil or criminal proceedings. So whatever the proceedings may be, it is a civil or a criminal proceedings going on before a court, and this person chooses to personate himself as another person. So he describes himself as another person, he personates, and for that he will be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 3 years, or with fine, or with both. Now another section that is mentioned later on in this chapter is section 229. So we will read that first, because that comes under the head of false personation. So it talks about personation of a juror or assessor. So whoever by personation or otherwise intentionally causes or knowingly suffer himself to be returned, empaneled or sworn as a juryman or assessor. So this person chooses to personate himself as a juror. Now we must understand that this section is no more useful, because the jury system prevailed in our courts, but it is not in use at present. We had abolished the jury system. So this section is not that important, but still you may want to know that anyone who personated himself as a juror would have been punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now let's move back to section 206 to 208 that talks about abuse of process of court. So section 206 and 207 punish the fraudulent acts designed to prevent seizure of property. Okay, now section 206 applies to a person who fraudulently removes any property with intent to prevent lawful seizure. So an authority is trying to lawfully seize a property, but this person fraudulently removes that property so that the lawful seizure of that property is prevented. So that person who so removes that property fraudulently would be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. And section 207 punishes a person who fraudulently claims such property. So anyone who is claiming such property would be punished with imprisonment for either description for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now section 208 talks about the prevention of collusive decree for sum not due and payable. So whoever fraudulently causes or suffers a decree or order to be passed against him at the suit of any person for a sum not due, or for a larger sum than that is due to such person, or any property or interest in property to which such person is not entitled. So if any person is trying to fraudulently cause or suffer a decree or order to pass against him at any suit for a sum that is not due, or for a sum that is larger than what is due, or for any property or interest in such property to which such person is not entitled, or if he fraudulently causes or suffers a decree or order to be executed against him after it has been satisfied, or anything in respect to which it has been satisfied, then in all of these cases, as he is acting fraudulently, he shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now section 209 talks about dishonestly making false claim in court. So whoever does so will be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years, and shall also be liable to fine. And section 210 talks about fraudulently obtaining decree for sum not due. So whoever tries to obtain a decree fraudulently for a sum that is not due against him, then in that case he shall be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. Now section 211 is a different head that talks about false charge of offense. So section 211 provides punishment for an offense of making a false charge of an offense with intent to cause injury. So this person knows that the other person has not made any committed any offense, still he makes a false charge against him with the intention to cause injury to that person. Now it covers two distinct offenses. They are institution of criminal proceedings and preferring a false charge. Now the first includes the second, but not the vice versa. That means preferring a false charge is included within institution of criminal proceedings, but preferring a false charge will not always include institution of criminal proceeding. If someone does so under section 211 and he institutes criminal proceeding, then he shall be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 2 years or with fine or with both. And if it is instituted with a false charge for an offense that is punishable with death or imprisonment for life or imprisonment for 7 years or upwards, then this person who is making such false charge will be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine. Now this is a big chapter, so we will divide it into two parts and we will read the rest of the heads in the next video. So that's all in this video. If you like my videos, then don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.